Welcome to this vUWS flash introducing vUWS, the university's learning management system. My name is Hermy Cortez and I'm a blended learning designer for the learning and teaching unit. In this episode, I will introduce you to some of the tools and features of vUWS. To enter a unit or vUWS site, click on a link under My vUWS Sites. Once you've entered a unit or vUWS site, the homepage contains similar modules such as What's New, Announcements, and Alerts. These are specific to the unit or vUWS site. The course content menu is located on your left and allows you to easily navigate through important information and the course content. Please note, it is up to your lecturer on how they organize their course content and information and what appears on the course content menu. For instance, you may access your unit outline and learning guide under Unit Information. You may also access assignments, quizzes, readings, resources under either Course Content or Learning Materials. You may also be able to find your library reading list under the Course menu. This is a link to a list of the required readings for the course. These lists can be divided into weeks as shown in this particular unit. From here, you are also able to search the library for further journal articles, books, or other resources using the search option. Let's take a look at one of the collaborative tools in vUWS, the discussion board. You can access discussion boards through a link on the course content menu or a link on the course content area as shown on screen. The discussion board is a tool where you can share your thoughts and ideas about class materials to your instructor and your peers. A forum, as shown on screen, is an area where participants discuss a topic or a group of related topics. Within each forum, participants can create multiple threads. If you want to reply to a post, simply click on the reply link. You now have access to the new features of the content editor. From here, you can embed media, add mashups, characters, symbols, or emoticons, and use the Video Everywhere tool within your reply. You can also keep it simple and make basic comments. For more information on discussions, please refer to the Blackboard On Demand Learning Center for Students at ondemand.blackboard.com/students. Finally, we'll look at how to submit an assignment. Assignments can be placed anywhere in a course. Your instructors should let you know where the assignment is located. Always check with your lecturer or tutor if you have any questions or concerns about an assignment before you submit it. For this example, we'll go into course content and open up an assignment. Assignment information lists instructions, the due date, the number of points possible, and any files attached. Be sure to read all the instructions carefully to ensure you successfully complete the assignment requirements. You can upload your assignment by clicking on Browse My Computer or Browse Content Collection and locating your assignment file. Your uploaded assignment will appear below the attached files. You can also enter additional information for your assignment or add comments for the instructor to read. When you're ready to submit, click the Submit button at the bottom of the screen. A message appears at the top of the screen to let you know your assignment has been submitted successfully. That is it for this episode. For more information, please visit the VUWS Information for Students site listed under My VUWS Sites, or you can visit the Blackboard On Demand Learning Center for Students at ondemand.blackboard.com/students.